Welcome, everyone. This is Ruben Comics Podcast. My name is Ruben, and today we'll be talking about Captain America, The First Avenger. I picked this movie because I like Captain America, his hero's journey, his character, and his quest. I invited my friend to watch it with me, and now we're going to talk about it. Without further ado, let's introduce our guest, Mr. Gray.
Ruben, great to be here with you. Thank you for having me.
Oh, no problem. All right. So, what was your favorite scene in the movie?
Yeah. First off, thank you for encouraging me to watch this movie. It just warmed my heart. It's always good to see a superhero do a lot of good and something that is a motivator for us all. So, thank you for making sure that I did get an opportunity to watch this movie. And there were several scenes that jumped out at me. One that just immediately comes to mind is when he was trying out for the Army and for this special team, and the drill sergeant tried to see who could thoughtfully climb up a pole and grab a flag, and they would get a quick ride back to camp if they could do it, and no one could climb the pole, and Captain America, being the bright young man that he was, just pulled the pin out of the pole, and the pole fell down, he grabbed the flag off it. I thought it was telling of how smart he was and his charisma. But if I had to pick my favorite scene, it's probably his first scene when he went in to rescue the POWs. This was after he had already taken a serum and transitioned into becoming Captain America. This was where he was trying to do a lot of good, and he kind of got stuck for a little bit where he was putting on shows for the troops instead of actually being there elbow to elbow with them fighting for the country, which is really what he signed up to do. And so he went in and rescued prisoners of war. It's really where I think he first learned about his superpowers and gained confidence. And you could see that as he was coming back in the camp and had all the POWs behind him. And his colonel had recognized him for what he had done. And Captain America was ready to turn him in because he basically disobeyed an order, and the colonel said that would not be necessary. And in that scene too, he jumped over that fire, and I think that was when he first was really testing his abilities and was able to do that. And so from there, he just kept building up his confidence and doing more good.
Yeah, really shaped the character.
Sure did.
Mine was when, after he got the shield, he's suiting up, bring his friends with him, and they're just taking down Hydra.
Yeah, he had built his dream team there, right, of friends he could trust that he could fight with, and even a Captain America needs his sidekicks there with him, right?
Most definitely. Done without them.
That's right. I hear, Ruben, Captain America is your favorite superhero. What quality speaks to you the most about Captain America?
See, what speaks to me about Captain America is, even before he got the serum, he was already a hero, standing up to bullies, and no matter how many times they wouldn't let him join the military, he never gave up, made him more who he was, I think.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense. He had a lot of heart. You could tell that he respected his power and had a lot of compassion for what he wanted to do. So it really spoke to him as a person before he ever became a superhero, to your point.
Next question. In the film before transforming into Captain America, he got bullied. Well, what advice would you give to someone being bullied who's not Captain America?
Yeah, I can speak from personal experience. I got bullied growing up. I liked how Captain America took the position of, you know, I'm not going to just take it, I'm going to stand up for myself. And I think that that's important. I think you need to tell whoever is doing the bullying that you don't care for it, you don't appreciate it, you don't want it, and be very direct about that. They need to know. They may not realize they're doing something that's hurting you, although most of the time it's obvious. And then if it continues to happen, we need to get help. We're all in this with a support network in most cases, and so whether that's a teacher or a guidance counselor or a principal or an adult, a parent, we can pull in friends and get help so that we're not in it alone. And if it keeps happening, there's a point where you just have to stand up for yourself and not just take the bullying, but push back. And so for me, getting physical is always a last resort, but if it comes to it and that's where you are, I found that when I had to go that route, the bullying stopped. And it was never my goal to hurt anybody, but you got to make sure that you're not getting hurt and that you do stand up for yourself.
That's a good point. It's always good to stand up to bullies, ask for help.
Yeah, and I find when you do it, others see it, and it gives them confidence too, right? So not only are you standing up to a bully, but you're standing up as a leader and giving other people hope that they can get past what they're experiencing as well.
Yeah.
So it's not just for us, right?
Right.
Why don't you tell me a little bit about the Red Skull? It got the best of him, didn't it? And do you have kind of an Achilles heel? He had his, for sure.
Oh, yeah. I would say my Achilles heel is biting off more than I can chew.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I wouldn't ask for help. He would offer to me. Like at the warehouse, there'll be a lot of orders. Instead of asking for extra help, I did it myself.
Man.
It was a bit of a mess. That's when I just asked help from my dad and we got situated.
Yeah, that's how you avoid something going from bad to worst, right? Which is kind of what the Red Skull experience with him being impatient and wanting to rush to get the serum produced to get his power. I know my Achilles heel is when I don't sit with something long enough, I tend to not make great decisions, and some of that becomes humorous, whether I've bought something that I then have to return because it didn't fit or didn't look good, all the way to making bad decisions in where I'm spending my time or how I'm being helpful to people. We all have our Achilles heel.
Absolutely. What would you say are five qualities for Peggy Carter, Captain America's girlfriend? Good and bad?
I gotta tell you, I'm a big Peggy fan, so I see her through a lens of a lot of good. I do think she is a serious person and could come off a little bit closed off, but I think she's a serious person. I think she takes her job serious. She wants whatever she's doing to be successful, including Captain America, building him into a superhero. I think we all want someone like that in our life. And it makes us a better person. And Peggy's a great example of that. She has real faith in Captain America. I think he feels empowered because of that. And she's got a great sense of humor. I loved when she told Captain America, go get him, when they were in that car and he was getting ready to jump on that plane. If I was Captain America, I would feel pretty good about myself going into a heated battle. And Peggy's really intelligent. She gets how to think about things and how to be helpful and drive results. And so I was very impressed by that character. We all need a Peggy in our lives.
Sure. And she knows how to fight.
She knows how to fight. I wouldn't want to mess with her. Who's your Captain America in real life, Ruben?
Let's see.
I want to say my Captain America is my dad. During my childhood, he helped me through elementary school. He taught me how to ride a bike, write cursive,
yep,
and fill out the orders at the warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
He always believed in me, and he still helps me through college.
Yeah, we're family friends, and I know that he believes that you can do great things. So he is absolutely a Captain America for you, and frankly just me being around him too. I learned a lot from him and value his friendship, and we all should have a Roger Gore, who's your dad, in our lives, right? Just like Captain America.
Can't argue with that.
If you did, he'd probably have something to say about it.
Yeah, I'm sure he would. I'd like to be like him someday.
Yeah, I agree.
Alright, at the beginning no one believed in Captain America.
Mm-hmm.
The military turned him down. Believed in himself. The scientists believed in him. Gave him a shot. That person in your life that...
Oh, that's a good question. I'd have to say it was someone who actually hired me while I was still in college. His name was Jerry Jones. He took a meeting with me at the request of my dad, and I thought there was no way that he was going to take me serious and want me to come work for him and his team. I had just lost a bet in college with a buddy and had to bleach my hair. I pulled up in front of the building where he worked, and I had a Jeep with no doors on it, and I'm not sure that I was even dressed presentably compared to folks that were out of college and had life more figured out. I thought I was just going to go work in a casino on the beach. So this was a big step from that, given this was a consulting firm. And I interviewed with him and his team, and they made me an offer, and it really kind of put me on the path that I'm on today with my career. And this was someone that believed in me and took the time to really develop me and help me understand how to do well in business. And him with one of his top guys, Chris Meyer, did that. And I've actually worked with Chris now for over 2 decades, 20 years, and still learning from him and doing things with him. So it was wonderful. I had friends there helping me along the way, and they didn't need to do that. And so I'm very grateful that I had folks believe in that. As you think, Ruben, about the movie, what was your favorite line in the movie? I'd mentioned my favorite one with Peggy saying, "Go get them." Do you have a favorite line?
I do. It's when he got cornered by the bully at the movie theater. He's in this alleyway. He gets getting knocked down. He just gets back up and say, "I can do this all day."
That's him not backing down the bullying, right? Him leaning into it and not showing fear. Another one I liked was at the end when he had been frozen for decades, and he was talking to somebody out in the streets of New York, and the person was trying to figure out why he seemed a little confused, and he's like, "Well, I had a date," and he was talking about Peggy, and you know, several years have gone by that he missed that opportunity. But Captain America always kept a good sense of humor about him. I appreciated that. I think that's important. Life can get hard sometimes, and if you can't have a good sense of humor, it gets even harder.
All right, here's a hidden fact question for our audience. So the scene from the convo where they were watching the guy with the car on stage, who was that gentleman, and what's his connection to Marvel?
I'm going to have to phone a friend. You have a much more detail-oriented view on things. Would you mind sharing, actually? I'm not sure I know the answer to that.
Sure thing. So the guy at the convo with the flying car was he was Iron Man's dad in the comics.
Okay. I gotcha. I just did a quick Google to try to see who he was, and I do recall him now. He was also a character actually in a TV show called Mad Men. I'm trying to recall the actor's name, but he was fantastic in that as well. So he's done a number of things. It's been fun to watch. Good catch on that. I would have never caught that, Ruben.
Sounds like a good show.
Yeah, it's worth a watch, for sure.
And just to close out, how would you rate the movie overall?
Kind of maybe finish where I began. I'm really glad that you brought this movie to me and encouraged me to watch it, because it just made me feel good about our country, our soldiers. Anytime I see a movie like that, it makes me grateful for our freedom. And when you throw it, superhero in the mix, you just can't go wrong, especially one that's supported by a great character like Peggy Carter. So I'd give it an 11, and I wouldn't rate movies that freely and with such a strong rating, but it checked all the boxes and then some for me.
I'll give it an 11 too. When watching it, I noticed some new details, like at the Red Skull's lair, when he had the painter, he had his mask off, but he turned off the lights so you couldn't see his face. That was a cool detail they had in there.
I think you've given your audience a few things to go back and look for now.
Yeah, yes I did. Well, that's about wraps it up for today's episode. Hope y'all liked it, and hope for more. See you soon.
This is Ruben Comics Podcast.
My name is Ruben. Next episode, we'll be reviewing and discussing Iron Man. Signing off. Ruben.